Now, according to a new study, staying optimistic helps you to fight disease. Scientists tracked the outlook and immune system of 124 students over the course of a year and discovered that those who were feeling more optimistic also displayed stronger responses to a challenge on their immune system. However, figures out today reveal that we're turning into a nation of pill poppers, with the number of prescribed medicines dispensed per person rising from 8 to more than 16 a year. So, what are we like, ladies, as patients? Are we guilty of popping a pill at the first sign of sickness?
No, I don't. I mean, I won't surrender to minor ailments, and I do sort of, you know, soldier on. But if I do think there's something wrong with me, and, you know, I think that human beings are quite instinctive in that sense, and I think if there is something wrong with you, you kind of know. And I do go to the doctors, you know, when I need to. I wouldn't say it was all the time, and I'm certainly not really a hypochondriac, even I say not really, because a lot of people think I am, but I'm not, but I'm quite persistent. But I have to say, this isn't all doctors, you know, because you never get to see the same doctors anymore. Some of the doctors I have seen have been rather too quick with the prescriptions, if you like, and sometimes for, you know, fairly harsh antibiotics, which I think antibiotics are, if they're overprescribed and people take them too often, you know, we know for a fact that they can destroy your immune system, and when you do need them, really need them, they won't work. So I will put off taking anything, and I won't even take a headache tablet until, you know, I can't stand it anymore. I'll try other things, you know, drink water. Usually that gets rid of a headache.
I think that's such a fantastic attitude. I know my husband would love you as a patient, Carol. I'm sure he would.
But for many...
No, he would. He would, love.
I mean, your health is your own...
Me up.
If you're nice to him. But I think it's really important, you know, to take responsibility for your own health. I mean, your doctor's there to advise you, not necessarily to make the decisions for you. But make no mistake, for many people, particularly the elderly, their lives have been transformed by tablets, by drugs. And, you know, many elderly people's lives have been extended dramatically by the incredible advances that we've had in our health service, because, you know, it really, really is an incredibly successful service. And I know from my husband that, you know, he tries, and all doctors try, to prescribe rationally for people so they get the right drug for the right person. But at the end of the day, the NHS is a cost-contained service. It's very successful, it's very well funded, but there are more cures, but more people, and, you know, those cures have to be spread around. And All of us, doctors and patients alike, really do have a duty to use the NHS properly. And I think you are, and I think that's great.
I also think, I mean, it is a mindset. I think positive attitude helps with everything. And unless, you know, you've got an infection like my spider bite I had not so long ago, you need antibiotics. We won't go there today. I'll tell you about it another day. Tell you about it another day. But, I mean, I was pumped full for 10 days full of antibiotics, because I knew that I needed it. But they do make me poorly. So I try, I mean, my sister would quite happily pill pop, I think. And I used to when I was younger. But I do think when I was feeling very low after I had Jake, you know, went to the doctors, and I didn't stop crying for 3 months. So she did give me some tablets. But I sat there and I looked at them and I thought, do I really want to do this? Threw them in the bin and thought, I've got to sort myself out. And I think with a positive attitude, you can get to a point.
Well, that's a brilliant illustration of kind of putting your mind over matter first. I mean, Prozac's helped an awful lot of people. But yeah, you're right. I think if it's something you feel that you can cure yourself, then you have to be your own doctor.
Definitely.
And you take responsibility for your own health in that respect. But there's no point in kind of, I can't bear this. It tends to be a very male attitude of, you know, seeing an illness through on your own, when actually a prescription and a course of penicillin antibiotics could clear you up and sort you out.
And of course, if you actually need them.
If you need them,
I have had experiences where I've been prescribed something, you know, I've been tested for things, and then I've been prescribed something before I've even got the test results back. And I just think, you know, a lot of people, you know, the doctor even said, oh, just, you know, you might as well just take these in case there is something there. But it destroys your immune system.
But you
get more infections.
You go to a doctor and you can read whether or not you feel safe in their hands, don't you? And I'm, you know, I think, again, you have to be your own doctor in pushing for a second opinion.
Yeah.
If you don't trust the advice you're getting, get a second set of advice.
Yeah, but the great thing is the advice is there, and generally speaking, it's wonderful advice. And I think all of us as women, particularly, who often have two jobs to have to do, you know, the job at work and then the job of looking after the home, I think we rely a lot on the health service, and I think it's brilliant. It's there, and it's so good for us.
You can't afford to be ill.
Exactly.
Yeah. I'll leave the men in charge. Jeez. OK. Now, the